How's everybody doing? My name is Peter. I'm your communications officer. I'm so happy to see all of you here today because the only way that we can win a fair contract is by putting pressure on the administration outside of the bargaining room. And let me tell you, I've been in the bargaining room and they're starting to move. They're starting to move. But we have to keep showing up at events like this and letting everybody know that we are the Graduate Employees Organization and we demand a fair contract with a living wage. So, we have a couple speakers for you here today. And first I'd like to introduce Kerry Pimblott, who is lead negotiator on the bargaining team, a PhD student in history, and she's going to talk to you a little bit about graduate education and the economy, which is the name of the conference that we were not invited to, but guess what? We showed up anyway. So here's Kerry.
But first of all, I want to talk a little bit about what's going on inside the room, because I know some people don't know what the conference is actually about. That's actually deliberate. They don't want you to know what the conference is actually about. It's about graduate education and the Illinois economy.
That's us.
Exactly. But we weren't invited to the conference. In fact, they kind of kept it very secret. And I hear this morning, after we asked for an invitation to the conference, they kept it even more quiet.
After we were invited to the conference, they've told us now that walk-in registration is closed. They will not be allowing any further GEO members in. No more graduate students at the conference on the graduate education in the Illinois economy.
So I guess we have to have our own conference outside the building. And I think we need to be really specific about what we're actually asking for in terms of graduate education and the state of the Illinois economy. And so I'm going to talk for my notes a little bit more closely because it is a bit more of a narrow topic than what we would normally say. But at the end, I'll come back and we'll talk about the stuff that we really care about, right? So first of all, I just want to say the people that are in the conference today are coming from three very specific groups. First of all, they've invited administrators to come and talk about their perspective on the graduate education and the state of the Illinois economy. So what is the state of graduate education according to administrators, and what is the future of graduate education in the context of the Illinois economy? Secondly, they decided to invite a group of economists to run a panel and talk about their perspective on graduate education and the state of the Illinois economy and how, and Rich, I thought initially maybe there'd be something positive there, but Rich told me that they're really focusing narrowly on the role played by scientists and engineers only, which great for scientists and engineers, we need more at the University of Illinois, but they're not talking about probably the rest of us that work in the humanities and areas like that, that provide educational kind of training in the state of Illinois. So very narrow in that sense. And then the third group, administrators, economists, and then also they've invited an entire panel representing corporate interests. So they have a panel. They have a panel of Illinois industry representatives. Thanks, Hannah. I'm talking louder. They have a panel of industry representatives who are going to come and talk about graduate education and the Illinois economy and what they think about that. What's been excluded, obviously, is the people that actually participate in graduate education, run all the classes, the people who actually are here getting a graduate education and have been affected by the policies of the administration, and the people who would probably have the best perspective and the most exact perspective on actually what's going down here at the University of Illinois right now, who gets access, who doesn't, and how difficult it is for people to stay in graduate education from working class backgrounds. And so that's what I want to talk about real briefly today. So why have graduate students been excluded and graduate employees? Probably because of something we've got to say that's really critical, and they're still not interested despite the fact their administration is a total shambles and most of them have had to resign. Now that's a sign that they're obviously not headed in the right direction, the fact we weren't invited here to talk today. But normally I focus on the negative things, but actually I think we're building towards something special because, as Peter said, things in the room are starting to change. I'll say the thing that changed things the most was when we had the intent to strike vote, and I could go back this week and say that we had done that unanimously and that we're going to put serious pressure on them to give us a decent contract. That worked! Oh, they want to schedule emergency sessions now this week. They want to be at Willard Airport or Assembly Hall or anywhere to talk about the contract because they are afraid, because they know we make the university work. quote, what do we have to offer the university in terms of a very clear statement? And when I say the university, not everybody gets represented. So what we're really talking about is the administrators, the economists, and the corporate interests that are in the room making the decisions. So this is what we've got to say, and this is at least what I do. There's maybe a broader array of interests, but I've tried to distill it down like at the last rally to kind of a central point. And so for us, this alternative vision of the university is based on the original founding idea of this university as a public institution with a land grab mission. And that means something very specific. It means that this university was actually created to make sure that working class people had access to higher education. Administration of the University of Illinois had an actual good idea, and things started heading down the wrong direction some point more recently. But what we're actually saying then is that this is not a radical fringe movement to get graduate employees decent pay and rights, even though I may want it to be. It's actually a more mainstream movement to ask for the university to make sure that the priority is its original mission, to have access for working people. And so I think what we need to be focusing on and telling the administration today is how their current policies violate the fact that this university is a land-grant university, and to tell them ways in which they can refocus the university in the appropriate direction.